Wrong Country. This is Sunday Mass. Bishop Greg Homeming.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let's once again implore God's love and mercy on ourselves and the whole world, that there might be peace and love everywhere. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are Son of God and Son of Mary, Christ of mercy.
Christ,
you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
The first reading is from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Tell the sons of Israel this: you must not molest the stranger or oppress him, for you lived as strangers in the land of Egypt. You must not be harsh with the widow or with the orphan. If you are harsh with them, they will surely cry out to me, and be sure I shall hear their cry. My anger will flare, and I shall kill you with the sword. Your own wives will be widows, your own children orphans. If you lend money to any of my people, to any poor man among you, you must not play the usurer with him. You must not demand interest from him. If you take another's cloak as a pledge, you must give it back to him before sunset. It is all the covering he has. It is the cloak he wraps his body in. What else would he sleep in? If he cries to me, I will listen, for I am full of pity." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm: I love you, Lord, my strength.
I love you, Lord, my strength.
I love you, Lord, my strength, my rock, my fortress, my saviour. My God, this is the rock where I take refuge, my shield, my mighty help, my stronghold. The Lord is worthy of all praise. When I call, I am saved from my foes.
I love you, Lord, my strength.
Long life to the Lord, my rock. Praise be the God who saves me. He has given great victories to his king and shown his love to his anointed.
I love you, Lord, my strength.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. You observe the sort of life we live when we were with you, which was for your instruction, and you were led to become imitators of us and of the Lord. And it was with the joy of the Holy Spirit that you took to the gospel, in spite of great opposition all round you. This has made you a great example to all believers in Macedonia and Achaia, since it was from you that the word of the Lord started to spread. And not only throughout Macedonia and Achaia, for the news of your faith in God has spread everywhere. You do not need to tell other people about it. Other people tell us how you started the work among you, how you broke with idolatry when you were converted to God and became servants of the real living God, and how you are now waiting for Jesus, his Son, whom he raised from the dead, to come from heaven to save us from the retribution which is coming. The word of the Lord. Please stand to welcome the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia. All who love me will keep my words, and my Father will love them, and we will come to them. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Is you, O Lord.
When the Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, they got together, and to disconcert him, one of them put a question to him. Master, which is the greatest commandment of the law? Jesus said, you must love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment. The second resembles it. You must love your neighbor as yourself. Of these two commandments hang on the whole law, the people also. The Gospel of the Lord.
Looking back on my life, it's really only since the death of my parents that I've actually begun to be able to ponder what love is. When your parents, those who love you more than anyone else, are alive, it's very much taken for granted. It's just part of what life is. And after they die, you wish that you had loved them adequately, but of course, as a child and as an adult, you don't really respond as you should. And as the years go on, you begin to recognize what they did for you. You begin to recognize how much of who you are is already them. In other words, that they're part of who you are. And in their personalities and in the people that they are, they continue to teach you how to love. I think that we'll all say something similar, that we act and love according to the way that our parents were to us and loved us. And that certainly is true. Today's gospel is about love. What's the greatest commandment? Love God with all of your heart, soul, mind, and strength. And the second, love your neighbor as yourself. It's a very easy thing to say, but who can tell me what this commandment really is? In fact, the understanding of this commandment, like the understanding of love that we have from our parents, is something which only emerges and becomes a reality which we begin to see within ourselves after the affliction of so much time. It's something we never understood when they were trying to teach us to love. And this commandment is not understood just by simply reading it and saying what it says, because it says nothing different to what was taught in the Old Testament. And on these commandments, in fact, three in number, everything hangs. Love God, love your neighbor, and love yourself. If only we knew how to do this. I will share with you something brief in regard to this, because This is a gospel passage that, please God, as every year goes on, as we read it, we understand more, because we learn the meaning of this commandment by reflecting upon love in our own lives and how love works. Because love is not fundamentally something commanded, but something which is experienced, and because experience is lived. The first way we look upon this commandment is about doing things. It's about doing things for others, doing things for God. But it doesn't seem to work. As I've pondered this in the 66th year of my life, it speaks to me of one amazingly important thing. I cannot love someone unless they have a space in my life. I cannot love myself unless I have space and time for myself. And likewise, I cannot love God except by giving God space and time. It's about presence. We don't love by doing things, but we learn to love ourselves by being present to ourselves and giving space and time to ourselves. We don't know how to love each other. It's certainly not about doing things, and yet doing things flow on from what love is. I learn to love you if I can find the time to give you space in my life, if I can find time to be present to you. But I only learn that by finding time to be present to myself. In being present to myself, I begin to learn what love is by how I've experienced love. And then, if I can be present to you, that engagement of presence is the place in which love is born. How can I love God? By saying prayers or by doing things? No. I love God by living in the presence of God and allowing God to be part of my life and in my life. So what do these commandments mean? We learn as we ponder our own lives. And as we ponder them, the meaning grows in us. It hasn't grown very far in me yet, but for me, as I ponder these commandments this year, it means time and space to be in the presence of myself, of you, and ultimately of God. And let's stand and profess our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Asking our Heavenly Father to teach us how to love and what love is, let us bring our prayers to him.
For the Church, our mother and teacher, guiding us to live according to the two great commandments. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders in government who love and serve their neighbours. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For widows and orphans and poor folk who cry out for justice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For apostolates of charity and community service groups in our community. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that all who are sick and bereaved may receive healing and acceptance through Christ and the intercession of St. Mary of the Cross. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the joy and peace of the faithful departed. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we make these and all our prayers through Christ our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being, and while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, Saint Teresa, Saint John of the Cross, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
We have died with
let us pray. May your sacraments, O Lord, be pray perfect in us what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in signs, we may one day possess in truth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace, Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Create a new heart, Holy Lord. Beckon our lives through your word. Open our eyes to your call. United as one for your world. Heighten our minds to your thought. Heal us of pride and of hurt. May we go forth in your name. We pray our hearts change.
Your Spirit's always healing and blessing and breathing, calling and stirring. Your Spirit's always speaking through us with